You know who has been absolutely incredible as of late? It's Milan Lucic. And this is a topic that I didn't really think I would ever make about this kind of player ever, but isn't it fair to say that the old Milan Lucic, the one that terrorized the league as a member of the Boston Bruins, is back? I certainly think he is. In fact, so many people have been writing about Milan Lucic and what he has been able to do as a member of the Calgary Flames at the 2020 Stanley Cup Playoffs. And you can read all the headlines. He is rewinding the clock. He has found a new kind of game with the Flames. One that's somewhat akin to what Milan Lucic was always good at doing, but one that is completely new to this kind of Flames team, especially in the playoffs. Milan Lucic right now has 5 points in 5 games played in the postseason. He's got a goal and 4 assists, he is second on the entire team in points behind Sean Monahan, and he's riding the Calgary Flames' first 5-game postseason point streak since Jarome Iginla. So yeah, there's a lot of value there. But honestly, it wasn't that long ago that we were just making memes about Lucic, talking about his contract, talking about a weird trade for James Neal, wherein many people said that the Oilers actually won because James Neal got just under 20 goals playing with the Oilers. But Milan Lucic has started to prove his value now, and it's in a realm where, albeit James Neal is not actually competing, so now there's a different stage for Lucic to show off his value and why he actually went for as much as he did in that trade all that time ago. If you haven't been caught up to speed, Lucic is playing on a third line with Sam Bennett and Dillon Dubé. And in fact, he's been mostly playing on the left wing throughout this entire time, but in game one against Dallas, Lucic got moved over to center and he went 11 for 16 in the dot. Tyler Seguin, who? This is an article over here from the Edmonton Sun talking about what Tyler Seguin actually said about Lucic taking all these draws. Honestly, I was surprised with Lucic in the draw. I had no idea he was a good faceoff man. He doesn't do anything out of the ordinary, he's just a strong guy. Before the game as a center, you look at the other centers, and I didn't have a look at one Lucic draw, so I'll definitely have to do some more homework. And it's not even just the dot that Lucic is excelling at. As we noted, 5 points in 5 games, a goal and 4 assists. His one-time pass over to Dillon Dubé that went cross-crease was amazing. It was the first goal of Game 1 against Dallas, and Lucic just looks at the puck, he slap passes that across the slot to a Dillon Dubé who shoots it and it goes in. It was incredible! Lucic has been proving himself as such a valuable member of this Calgary Flames team, and the numbers don't even reflect how good of an impact he is making. Because sure, he's had that offensive flair just somehow reignited back in there, scoring goals and finding himself assists, but the way that third line plays with Dubé and Bennett, those two guys are starting to amp up the physicality and the overall intimidation that the Calgary Flames are providing out there on the ice. And a lot of that has to do with the overall mentorship that Milan Lucic is giving to these guys. I didn't even realize until I actually tuned into a game and saw Sam Bennett and Dubé actively playing physically. This is way different than the 18-year-old Sam Bennett meme that I'm used to. And in fact, the Lucic that I'm watching is a lot more akin to the Lucic of old. The old Lucic that everybody thought McDavid was going to get as somewhat of a next-generation version of Dave Semenko. And man, just seeing how Lucic was able to rebound and become so great again, it's such a refreshing story. I took a look at this article over here on the Sportsnet. It's called Flames Lucic Rediscovers Passion for Game with Dramatic Resurrection. It's written by Eric Francis. It was published earlier yesterday. And it starts off by talking about how Lucic almost considered retiring because when he started out in Calgary, he wasn't really given all that much of a great role. He said it just wasn't fun for him anymore. Well, after the coaching change and after finding his way onto a third line with Bennett and Dubé in the playoffs, This one short little sentence kind of sums up everything. Everything Lucic has touched this summer has turned to gold, providing leadership and mentorship to a young team that feeds off his playoff knowledge, experience, and adrenaline. Reminder, Milan Lucic has a Stanley Cup. And sure, I may not like being reminded of that all too much, but he's made the Cup Finals twice, and he's a guy who can definitely use that experience to contribute to the positive development of his teammates on Calgary. In fact, just taking a look at the entire story as to how he got here is so interesting to me. Because I got into hockey around 2011. That was the time when Milan Lucic was 23 years old, he was still somewhat of a young guy, and he still had a lot more to prove at the NHL level. And sure, I get that 2011 was literally the best season that he ever had, but watching this guy in the playoffs and watching what he did in the regular season was super noteworthy to me because he established himself as that physical guy. When you thought about a physical guy who can fight, who can score, who can rack up penalty minutes and just get under the opponent's skin, you thought of Milan Lucic. He was that big-bodied presence before. And I'll be honest, Lucic's one and only year in LA, which a lot of people would define as maybe the year that he started to decline, I honestly thought it was not that bad. Sure, there was the whole contract thing, whether or not he'd re-sign, and that's the reason he even got traded was because Boston didn't want to give him money, but he was still pretty good. It's just that one off-season in 2016, where the Okpozo deal got signed, the Eriksson deal got signed, the Lucic deal got signed, where all the really bad contracts in the league today kind of got signed. Yeah, he went to Edmonton, and that was kind of a bad fit. At least, not really early on, because even early on, he still got 23 goals in his first year and 50 points. Certainly not a bad number. It's just, compared to what he would bring, hey, this guy's supposed to be a big physical fighter, why does he only have 50 penalty minutes? The next few seasons in Edmonton saw Lucic get fewer and fewer points, which in turn led to the reputation that we built for Lucic in the most previous season, which in turn led to him getting traded for James Neal. Now, Neal was seen as an immediate win. He didn't really click with the Calgary Flames system, but hey, this guy's gonna be playing with McDavid and or Dreisaitl now. There's no way this guy doesn't start producing, and for the most part, yeah, he did just that. It's honestly really funny to me how James Neal got 19 goals and 12 assists. For a good part earlier on in the season, the guy had like so many more goals than assists, and it's kind of come with the territory with the real deal James Neal, the guy who scores 20 goals every single year. But hey, we didn't see that in Calgary, and all these factors combined, along with Lucic's not necessarily amazing play with Calgary at the beginning of his tenure there, was kind of what made everybody set in their heads, yeah, Edmonton won. By a lot, too. They won by a landslide. But now, oh man, this right here, this Milan Lucic is what they wanted to get. And after the coaching change, after defining the roles on the team, after giving him an opportunity to really showcase himself off as a good NHL player, it's almost like he has never even left from 2011. Now, I get that he's older, he's literally 9 years older than he was in 2011, I get that. But still, you can't deny with the records, man. This guy's legitimately playmaking, he's getting physical, he's setting the tone for his team, and he gave the Dallas Stars a really difficult time. Game 2 is on later today at the date of this video's upload at 7:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, and I would not be surprised if Milan Lucic continues that point streak. 5 points in 5 games against a whole bunch of teams that didn't really think that he had it in him to do this well. And to think that this guy got a goal taken away from him against Winnipeg too. We all kind of memed that because, yo, he just got a goal. That's crazy. But then he went and did it again, and then he got more assists, and then he started producing, and now he is one of the top point producers in the entire playoffs. It is 2011 again, I swear to all things goodness gracious. So talk to me in the comments below what you thought about Milan Lucic's play so far. I know I have been very impressed. I'm just wanting to know if anybody else is impressed with that too, because it's been a very hot topic, and I know that there are probably a lot of people who have some strong opinions about this. So talk to me in the comments what you think about Milan Lucic. I hope you enjoyed this video. So, and bye.